Just a second. Gotta set up the chats. Am I live right now? Is this working? All right. Now this bit's here. Okay, cool. See. I suppose we can start here. Gotta import these files. So, why is this private? So we're importing some files now. If you hear the fan, that's just temporary while I import the photos, because it's like 400 some photos and it's gonna take a while to import them. Not too long, of course. Let's let people know we're live. We'll let people know. So if you're in chat, feel free to say something. Hope you don't mind the jazz music, but it's public domain, so I won't get sued or copyright struck if I use it. So what I'm doing these days is I'm trying to edit all my older photos and keep like the really, really best ones so I can make a book someday. Like a real book, not a Zine book, you know what I mean? I thought this one might have some. I don't like it. Not this one. See, I take a lot of pictures, but most of them people never see. Nice face. This is so-so. I kind of like her expression though. It's kind of sneaking around. Sneaky, sneaky woman. Okay, this one has some promise, so I'm gonna edit it and maybe someday I'll decide to use it or not. Still not sure. Let's see. Gotta make these pop out a little bit more. I like the picture, but it's not a picture I would put in a book if I made one. But I'm gonna export it just to have it someday, you know, useful. I have like so many of these pictures that are just, they're not bad pictures, they're just not great pictures, you know what I mean? But I wouldn't go so far as to call them good either, just not worthy. This one, maybe. One of these two. I think maybe this one. But I don't like her dress. That's the only thing. It's like, plus it's kind of noisy, so I think this was when I was first learning to shoot street photography at night. And you know, these days I underexpose by like one stop, but back then I was experimenting, so I would underexpose by like two stops just to see how it worked out. And yeah, I mean, I guess it doesn't matter if you're making prints and only pixel peepers care, but still. Even I have my limits, you know? It's still nice. Maybe I can put this in Patreon. It's good to visit old photos. I'll put this in Patreon. But yeah, if you're in the chat, feel free to say something because I feel like I'm talking to myself. Not cool. See, back then I used to try all kinds of edits. You know, this one's a little too much, but you know, I was just learning, so it's okay. I want something with like all a bunch of shadows. Not so interested in people in my photos so much. They're kind of just extra, you know. To me, anyways. I know a lot of street photographers focus only on people, but for me, they're just extras. Not really something I focus on in my pictures. Yeah, nice balance of colors there. Oops. Maybe I'll... Actually, this photo's not bad. Not terrible, but not bad. Whoops. Noisy if you pixel peep though, but whatever. I want the white umbrellas to pop out a little bit more, so I'm gonna just give them a little bit of exposure. I'm pretty sure this picture is not going to be in any books of mine because it's really not great. It's just, it's okay, just alright also. I'm going to export it. I think my editing has improved a lot since back then. But yeah, this was like underexposed by 2 stops. When I was just learning. This one looks good. Let me just see if I can find. Yeah, I'm gonna copy these settings and post it to all of them so I can see better. I can choose the one I want better. Maybe that one. Or that one, I don't know. I'm leaning towards the first one. Oh, this one's also good. Put a star here. Oh, these are guys. Okay, I thought there were a couple. Well, no judgment, you know. So it's either this one or this one. This one fits the rule of thirds more, right? So we're gonna go with that one. But I kind of like this one much more. Yeah, we're gonna go this one. I like that very much. I want the area around him to be a little bit more bright, so that way he stands out more. Like that. Maybe not this far right here, but I can go back and erase it. Oh yeah, Lightroom is for editing pictures easily and quickly. Like, all these tools is just for editing the colors and the brightness and the contrast and all that stuff. Photoshop is more like for manipulating the picture, like removing stuff and adding stuff. So when you have like hundreds of photos like this, I much prefer Lightroom. When you want to dedicate your time to one picture, I would still use Lightroom, but if you want to take away stuff, like there's trash in a photo and you don't want it there, then I would use stuff like Photoshop. Or you can do what I do, is I edit in Lightroom all these things, all these changes, and then when I want to go in there and clean up stuff, I right click, edit in Photoshop. Hey, Plus, you can copy and paste the settings to the photos. Yeah, this is really nice. I want it to look more like a painted picture, so I'm gonna go in there and increase the luminance a little bit more, just like that. Bam. Lovely. That one is definitely book material. Export. Yeah, like maybe I'll take hundreds of photos. Like, this is like, how many pictures is this? This is 435 photos, but maybe I'll take like one nice picture out of every 40 or something, you know what I mean? 3 stars. So it's not like every photo I take is amazing. Okay, we're gonna copy and paste these settings just to see. We can copy the brush stuff, we gotta do that manually, but it'll give me a good idea. Damn, actually that looks pretty good too. Okay, I'm gonna export both and then maybe people can tell me later what they like. Yeah, no harm in exporting both. Okay, here's a couple. Yeah, people, especially here on YouTube, will be like, you gotta wait for the perfect moment and click and take the picture or whatever, but nah, it's not like that. In reality, just you take a lot and maybe you'll get a good one. You know what I mean? I mean, unless you're shooting film, it really does matter, but this is digital. This is okay, but it's too noisy for me. Like, there's too much going on, too much light. I like photos when there's like a little bit of light. Like, this is a, I don't know. I like it, but I don't like it. Like, this is a good, this is good for digital artists. Like, they're looking for like background references, but maybe not good for like printing. So I'm gonna go ahead and export it. This is good reference material, I think. You might make a good background. And there's some red washed out, so I'm gonna bring back some of that red. Over here. Okay, it might be a little bit too much, so I'm gonna scale it down. Just like that. And reduce the highlights, just the color. Yeah, there's so much you can do, but it all depends on your eye, like what you like to do. Sometimes I just go out there with like a really long lens and just focus on small details, but usually I like just catching the entire atmosphere. There, this is really good reference material. I'm gonna make an art pack for people with this. There we go. Nice, crispy. Export. I like this sign very much. That's why I took this photo. Yeah, that's what I do. I just go on long walks and take some pictures. Actually, today is supposed to rain, so I might go out for a walk. Okay. I like, but I don't like. This is one of those. I mean, I know for people outside Korea, this is not a common scene. But I see this all the time, so I'm just kind of tired of taking this kind of picture, you know? Oh, this is not noise, by the way. This is rain. It looks noisy, but it's actually just rain. Actually, I like that. I like that rain. Yeah, I shoot auto, but usually I'll shoot like F4 or something, and then the rest is all auto. Cause F3.5, F4. I want to get everything in focus. You don't need a You don't need a fast lens. Contrary to what other people tell you to. You just need a steady hand. I really want to make this rain pop out though, so I'm gonna get a brush. Okay, it already has highlights. It's a small change. Look at all this rain, it's cool. But yeah, I mostly just shoot auto, aperture priority. I shoot a lot, I move quickly, and I take lots of photos. I don't have time to stop and edit, change manually all the settings for every picture, because then you're gonna miss a lot of pictures, you know what I mean? You want to focus on capturing the picture. No camera, it's okay. Just like that. This is okay, but it's not something I put in my book. Just my reference packs. But yeah, I'm trying to make a book. I can show you some of the pictures I have already. These are the files I like, these are the files I kinda like, and this is a book about Japan or something. But here I have all my best pictures that I want to put in the book someday. This is snow, actually, snow in Jono. Yeah. Pretty cool, right? So these are my best photos I've taken. This is Namsan Tower in the back. It looks like the Eye of Sauron. Snowing. I have a lot of snow pictures. I love this photo. I took this one with my phone. This is full spectrum camera. It's very rare to have beautiful clouds like this. I think this one is also a phone shot, but it's just so awesome. This is a tunnel. It's really cool with infrared camera. This is with a 500 milliliter lens. Millimeter? Not millimeter. I'm using my retainer from my braces, so if I speak weird, that's why. Hong Kong. I love Hong Kong. Look at this guy down there. Yeah. So yeah, these are gonna be like my book photos someday. I love this picture. Yeah, I just wanted to show you. And this is the photo that won me the Cyberpunk 2077 contest with the on and off switch. Cool, right? Okay, let's keep editing. I got too many pictures like these, which they're cool the first time, but when you take so many of them, they're just kind of Yeah, I have no idea when I'm gonna write a book, but I'm preparing the files so that someday I can make a book. Eventually. I have no idea how to do it. This is also good reference material, so I'm gonna export it. People don't even see me half the time because I'm so fast. Because you know, I have the camera on like aperture priority or auto, so I just go take the photo and I get out of there. So people almost never notice that I took a photo, you know what I mean? Yeah, if you were shooting manual, you'd be there and people will find you and stuff. Oh, this guy is smoking a cigarette. In the rain. So actually, this was a pretty decent photo. I can't decide if I like this photo or not, because I know a lot of people like this photo, but it's just that usually people are not the focus of my photos, you know, it kind of disrupts the entire, it disrupts what all my photos are about. If I have a bunch of like landscape, cityscape photos, and then there's one picture of a guy smoking, So maybe not. I don't know. Yeah, welcome, Nick. We're here. Just no editing. It's really just a bunch of retouching. See? I guess I'll export it. My people are usually dark and you can't see them. I'm not a people person. See, this one was underexposed too much, so you have all these shadows, noise. I screwed up on this one. That's okay. It's not a big deal. I don't think I like it anyways. Whoops, too blue. I'm gonna skip that one. Oh, this one's interesting. See, I like pictures like this where there's people doing weird stuff that you don't usually see because it makes people look at the photo a bit more. Like, what's going on here? This guy's running. Why is he sideways? On second thought, I don't like it. Never mind. I stayed here a while trying to get like a better photo. Yeah, but I'm not really into that whole storytelling stuff. I just take photos because they look good. Although I like this red right here, I might edit this one. Yeah. This is the angle that gets more light and better composition. I think we're gonna settle with this one because it has this red on the bottom and it's gonna look really good when I edit it. Too noisy though. This was when I was just learning, so there's a lot of my pictures are underexposed too much. See, it helps if I lower the contrast though. Increased luminance looks much, much better. Okay, I'm gonna add a little bit more red to this. That's too much control Z. I'm just gonna like that. Nope. Sounds complicated. I like to keep things simple and easy. I don't want to think about things too much. I just want to paint. The small changes that change everything. Yeah, we're using royalty-free music, because not royalty-free, public domain music. So I don't want to get hit by a copyright strike from YouTube again. They keep all the money, you know. I mean, it's not like I make much, but they do it to everybody, and they end up keeping all the whatever they can from people. No problem, Alex. Always good to see you. It'd be cool if this was like moving, like if I made like a little animation with this like actually moving. That'd be nice. Okay, final touch, a little bit of texture, a little bit of clarity. And this is book material. Export. 3 stars. Ah, yes. I remember this. Let's go for like a real crazy look. Nah, not that crazy. Never mind. But a little bit more orange would be okay. Thank you very much. I think this is fine, just like that. Oh, what's this? Okay, that's just artifacts, I guess. This is going to be like a good reference photo for artists. Not the kind of thing I post on Instagram. It's just something that people can use when they draw their pictures, you know what I mean? Let's play around with the white balance and see if we can find some different things. No, I think that's it. See, I don't like tungsten lights because they're very hard to deal with. You can do it too, man. I believe in you. But yeah, tungsten lighting, this orangish, yellowish lighting is very, very, very difficult to play around with. You know what I mean? It's like really hard. But it kind of works here. We can go for like a faded, saturated, kind of unsaturated kind of look. Like a 50s noir or something. Actually, this looks good black and white. But I don't do black and white that much. But I kind of like it. Not gonna lie, maybe we should do a black and white. Because it looks cool. Yeah, I like that. That's much better. Much better than before. Okay. We'll keep that one. I don't do black and white very often because it's kind of hard to deal with. Yeah, I remember I like this. Here's the place. This is one of my best pictures right here. When I was just getting started. Here's a photo where some guys are like standing. I think it's this one. They're having a cigarette. Or was it this one? I guess the one with the hand is the good one. This one was really, really hard because this is like an LED panel. So it's like pointing your camera straight at the light source. And trying to get the details is almost impossible. So I had to underexpose, otherwise you will not see any of this writing. But then you can bring some stuff back. But you get the noise, you see? Noisy. But no one's ever complained in my prints. So we're gonna have to compromise. Keep it dark, but not too dark. That's gonna be hard. Too blue. Okay, how did I edit this picture? We're gonna mess around with the white balance and try to find something that works. I'm looking at the preview over here. It tells me what it's gonna look like before I actually do it. Gives me some idea. I guess we do settle for something like this, but reduce saturation a little bit. And I don't like this yellow. We're gonna go for like a monochrome kind of look. I don't know if that's right, just one color, right? Doesn't mean black and white, just one color. So we're gonna go to yellows, oranges, and unsaturate that. But I'm gonna increase the luminance, give them kind of a white look, like that. Okay, so we're here, but it's still very noisy. We're going to increase the luminance. It's looking better already, but it looks too contrasty, so we're gonna reduce the contrast. That helps a lot. Not something many people do, but it works in my case. The unsaturated parts are not looking so good though. Alright, you need a good picture first. I'm gonna go to the shadows and add a little bit of color. I mean, it's gonna add it to the whole picture, but I'm most interested in the back over here. You gotta compromise. I guess something like this. But we're gonna get a brush and color in these spots. We're gonna try to match the color. Something like that. Maybe a little bit more. Or maybe I could go for like purplish hue for variation. We'll decide later to see. Yeah, monochrome can look pretty good. If you know what you're doing. Yeah, that looks much better, to be honest. Just the finishing touches right here, right there. We're gonna leave the sign white like this. There's still the problem of the noise and the shadows, but actually if you make it darker there's gonna be less noise, something many people don't think about. So we can reduce the noise in these people by simply making them darker. And it also outlines their silhouette much more. Got smoking teenagers. Problem is he wearing a backpack? I guess he was, I don't know. So it is a little noisy, but you know, this is like one of my best prints. People don't really care. Actually, it kind of adds to the atmosphere, you know? The greediness. Make sure we get the hand and the clothes. Hair, and finally the hand. Okay, and we gotta get the legs, very important. Just a little trick of the trade to getting rid of shadows, I mean getting rid of some noise. Yeah, well, there is noise reduction, and we already used it, but if I use it too much, yeah, it's good when I'm going for that kind of painted effect, but in this case, is a really, really, really compromise between details and noise. Okay. Please excuse me for like 1 minute while I take off my retainer, because my wife brought me some coffee and I can't drink with a coffee retainer. 1 second. Okay. I should be able to speak much more clearly now without the retainer. We're still not done with this picture, by the way. Sorry about that noise. We need to make this a little brighter. I'm gonna brighten up the sign. That might be a little bit too much. We can always go back and change it. Don't worry. No problem. Yeah, those settings actually work really good, but since this picture is really, really, really underexposed, doesn't work so well for me, sadly. Okay, we're gonna reduce this. Yeah, like that. That looks good. Gotta make sure. Make this a little bit bigger. Get it nice and uniform. See, this is why one of the reasons I don't do presets is because you can't do this with a preset, you know. People would buy your presets thinking they're gonna get pictures like yours, but then they would just get disappointed when they spend their money and it doesn't look anything like yours. You know what I mean? Okay, now we cannot forget these reflections over here. Alright, now there's a lot of shadows and they have a lot of noise, so I'm gonna go in there and I'm gonna make those shadows a little bit darker, not by a lot, just enough to remove some noise from them, you know. Trust me, it adds a lot to the photo. You add a lot by taking away. And we're gonna add a little vignette. And voila! The picture is complete. Definitely one of my book material pictures. Keep going. I don't remember why I took this photo. Oh. This one's also good. Actually, my friend James Lucian was with me on this day and he posted this picture on Instagram. I have it too. I remember I posted this once on my story and someone called me like a cheat, like, you stole so-so's picture, blah blah blah. I'm like, no man, we were shooting together on that day. You know how people are. I like the view here. Here's another thing, like, I don't like cars in my photos because they kind of ruin the dystopian look that I'm going for, you know? It's like, I like motorcycles, but cars just kind of... I gotta go back. Yeah, like if I need to cheat, there's no reason to. But you know, there's people like that. Oh, I remember someone on Instagram someone on Twitter wanted this picture. Hey, everything's good. I told them I'll send them this photo, but I couldn't find it because I have so many photos, but I think I found it. One second, let me check my messages. What is this one? Okay, this one was shot on a phone. And this one is shot with a DSLR. So he wanted these specific colors, so we need something with a little bit of blue. Wait a minute. Let me see if I got someone with an umbrella. No. It's okay. I want one where it's like a silhouette of him. This one will do. Everything's going pretty good. Oh, it's because I'm using my phone to have the music. And I'm using the iPad to watch the chats. Yeah, most of the good ones are on a phone. This is when I was just still learning. How did I do this? Okay. Sometimes I forget how I edit stuff, you know. I'm gonna try to replicate my own pictures. You know what I mean? Darn. Okay, how did I do it? Something like that. Okay, I think I need to reduce the shadows a little. And then I need to change the reds into a little violets, like that. And the yellow is a little too green, so I'm gonna push them towards the orange. Increase the luminance. Yeah, it's a royalty-free, no, not royalty-free, public domain radio. It's green. Here we go. Pop that luminance up. There's a little bit more purple. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna grab a brush. Actually, maybe I don't need a brush. Maybe I can use a graduated filter. Like that. And you know, I try my best to. The lighting is different. Like here, some lights are on, and here they're off. Therefore, the color is not going to be the same. I don't think he'll mind, though. I think he'll probably appreciate that I'm trying my best to give him the picture he asked for. But we're going to try to do what we can. Time to paint. I think that looks pretty close. Maybe a vignette. Oh, and of course, luminance. Fix that right up. Yeah, pretty close. Maybe remove some shadows here. Yeah, it is funny how my phone photos are usually better. You know what I mean? Okay, I think this is pretty good. I'm gonna export it. Actually, I'm gonna do another edit. A different one, not for him, but for me. No, I'll keep that one. I actually like that. Just like a little bit brighter. This one's good book stuff, you know? Did you ever have an urge to do different style and afraid of what people think, kind of? Yes, all the time. I want to try new things, but most of the people that follow me for like the rainy, neon, cyberpunk stuff. But they seem to like the anime stuff too. But what worries me the most is YouTube. Because YouTube is... Most of them follow me for this kind of thing, not the anime stuff. But I like the anime stuff, you know. I'm gonna paint the sky a little bit more pinkish. But you know, it's okay, like, it is my channel, right? So I can do what I want. But I also try not to be too different, because then my audience stops watching. That's a problem. Okay, this is, I like this though. I would put this in a book. Maybe less saturated. Okay, so I'm gonna export this as a different unique name, and I'll send him one version, and I'll keep the other version for myself. Okay, I'll be back like in 2 minutes. She stole the coffee from me. I have to go get the coffee back. 1 second. Don't go anywhere. By the way, it's supposed to rain tonight. Let's see. So, weather by the hour. So if it rains, I'll probably go out and do like a live stream. Shooting live stream. It's supposed to start raining around 4 p.m. But yeah, if it rains, like in 5 hours, 6 hours, I'll be out. If you're awake. This is a nice picture. I like it. It's one of my best. And I took it when I was just starting. Ah, I remember. I remember editing one of these photos. I like the monochrome purple palette like this. Like I like this kind of look. Red is a beautiful color. I'm accentuating it with a little bit of purple in the shadows. just like that. Yeah, maybe this will be in the book. No. Three stars. Though this one's pretty good too. Let me copy the settings and see how it looks. If it works, I will go in there with a brush. Okay, maybe not so much. See, it's just a little small change and changes in color changes the entire photo, so you can't just use the same stuff. Not the feeling I was going for. I remember I took this picture because I was interested in trying that anime stuff. No, this is good reference material for anime. Maybe I can go in there and try to do an anime edit of this, because I remember I took this picture specifically for that purpose. So I'm gonna export it. And then here I have TIFF files of previous edits. As you can see, I was just learning to do what I'm doing, so the pictures are different colors, different styles. Trying new stuff. Hey, I did export it. I like this. No, maybe I'll post it on my Instagram and I'll get people telling me I stole it from my friend that I was shooting with that night. Or I'll just tag him and let people know we shot together. Okay, so we're going to delete all of these raw files because I already made a backup of them, alright? Don't delete your raw files. I have backups of my backups, and I have another backup of all those backups, so I can erase this one, okay? Plus, I need the space and I'm poor, so just so you know. So you can see I'm pretty low on the space. The Japan drive, the street drive, it was actually on the red, but I've been deleting stuff after I edit them. Yeah, this is the way I like it, you know, just hang out. No gear talk, no fighting, no this camera is better than that camera. Just photography, you know? Oh, why is this so, Maybe I'll delete League of Legends. I usually just play it in the winter, because I can't go out. Okay, so yeah, we deleted that folder. Okay, let me explain what I'm doing. I'm going back through all of my pictures since like 2017, 16. And I'm editing the photos I took all over again, and the ones I like I'm putting in a book. I'm gonna make a book someday. So we finished July, now we're going to, oh, this was when I used to have the Fuji, long time ago. That camera is long gone. I gave it away to my student. She's cool, she comes out in my videos sometimes. Okay, so we're gonna import all these pictures. It's only 149 photos. I'm surprised. And while this imports, I'm going to brush my teeth because I don't want coffee stains on my teeth. I'll be back. Okay, did it finish importing? I don't know if you can carry me. I play on the Korean server. The highest I've gotten is plat 1. Ah. Looking at this bokeh, I can tell you this was probably with the Super Takumar 51.4. Probably. Yeah, because I missed a lot of shots. Did I? Which lens is this? I don't know. Wait, no. This is not the TAC, because I was just... because I was still using the Fuji at the time. What happened here? Why are my photos like that? Did I... oh yeah, I didn't have my settings. I think I had it on manual focus at the time. So I missed a bunch of pictures. I forgot to put in autofocus. You know... that happens. Mistakes happen. This is good reference material. You can go back and see all your mistakes, like, oh, I forgot the autofocus. I'll put this one in the reference pack for artists. I usually just play Singed or Teemo top. Malzahar if I have to go mid. Or Annie. And Nunu if I'm jungle. Sometimes jungle Teemo. And if I have to go support, I'll play Soraka or... yeah, mainly just Soraka. That's it. I remember... this alley. But I have much better pictures of this place. This was the first time I found this place. But I remember that the bike was in the way and I didn't like it. This is good reference material though, so exploits. Make a nice pack for artists. Oh, is there a person there? Okay. Yeah, sometimes that happens, but You can actually fix some adapters. There's like a removable thing to help you infinity focus. Remove plates, adapter, infinity. Like many adapters, you can remove the plate so that you can do infinity focus, and it'll teach you like online. I wish I had a better photo here. Like, yeah, like, for example, maybe this one? No, not that one. I'm sure if you Google it, you'll find it. Because I had that problem before. Like, you see this thing right here? This metal inside? Some of them you can take it off. And it's designed to be taken off, so you can do infinity focus. We'll get back to editing right now. I'm just gonna try to help. Here's a nice tutorial. You remove that. Yeah. You can see the difference. I mean, it varies. There's different adapters to different things. Without infinity focus, with infinity focus. You can also get internal reflections with some of these, so you gotta watch out. Anyways, back to editing. This is still my beginner day, so there's a lot of mistakes. My newbie photos. This would be good reference picture. Actually, I have an idea. Because it looks like it's kind of parted in the middle.
It's like a 5 inny bay.
Oh, that sucks. Well, time to update the adapters. We're gonna do like one side kind of blue and one side kind of purple. See, that's what I like about photography. You just mess around. Do whatever you want, kind of deal. Try new things. Yeah, just a search for M42 adapter with infinity focus. And you get a bunch of them, you know. Did I export this? Okay, I did. Lots of bad photos here. Well, that's okay. People never see the bad pictures, they only see the good ones. Still bad. This one looks cool though. As you can tell, I was still learning at this point. I have like 6 different cameras and I use all of them, and I got like 20 different lenses and I use all of them, so yeah, there's no one thing I use. I even use my phone a lot. And I have more than one phone. I got like 3 or 4 phones because companies send them to me to use them. I don't promote them on social media, of course. They use them for like their private meetings. Like, oh, this guy uses this phone. Check out the photos he did. This is great reference material right here. Sure. We're gonna export this for the art pack. I have one for Japan, I don't have one for Korea yet. When I took these pictures, I was just starting, and at the time, I was underexposing because I thought it might help, but I would underexpose too much. Like, I would do like 2 stops underexposure, and that was like way, way too low. But one stop is the sweet spot, you know? What's that guy doing? Still, you get some nice effects. No, these are bad photos. No denying it. Some bad pictures. This is when I found this spot and I thought it was really cool, but as you can see, the picture sucks. Or maybe we can save it. It's a good reference material. We're gonna leave that one there. I haven't found a picture I like yet, so we're gonna keep going. Really? No, these pictures I took in like 2018. I started doing this stuff like around 2017, 2016. Actually, I started like 2015. It took me a long time to develop the skills I have now, you know? Like, I was taking these photos, but I didn't know how to do it properly, you know what I mean? Like, I was just walking around taking pictures in the street of stuff at night. Like, this is a cool photo. But, as you can see, I missed the focus. I screwed that up. It'd be so nice if I can just delete these people. Maybe we can improve on this photo. Yeah, like, this was one of the pictures I was proud of, despite the blurriness. But I didn't mind. It looks cool, I think. See, little editing needed. This is a building in Seoul, by the way. Yeah, I was a newbie. Actually, I do like this. You know, it's just not perfect, but it still looks alright. Not bad for 2000s, whenever this was. Okay, we're gonna take out the feather. See if we can salvage this photo a little bit at least. Like, I have a lot of pictures that I do like, but they're just like, technically they're not very good, but they're still good pictures, you know what I mean? I can see this being in my book, but I would have to really think about it. Like, I could put this at the beginning and let people know when I was first starting out, these are the kind of photos I would take. While they're not perfect, I still feel proud of them. And the concept is good. You know, actually, it's a little too purple. Yeah. Something like this is better. Crispier. I like that. It's funny what just a small change in color can do for your photo. That's cool. Maybe the yellow is a little too much, so I'm gonna just reduce the yellow a little bit. Not a lot, just enough. Yeah, this is not bad. Yeah, when I first started, I would also shoot everything in manual because that's what the YouTuber said. You're not good unless you use manual. Actually, I think I was using manual here. That's why I screwed up so much. But, no wait, I wasn't because I was doing it. I was experimenting with exposure compensation at the time. Never mind. But that's the nice thing about shooting raw is that you can still... this one's not bad either. Oh. It's always nice to like go back and discover these old forgotten pictures that are actually not that bad. I kind of like this too. This one or this one? I think this one's cool. Play around with the colors. There we go. This is cool, but this English is bothering me because it kind of ruins the mood of the photo, you know what I mean? So this is gonna be one of the rare times I open Photoshop. Except when I do the anime pictures. I use anime for that, the Photoshop for that. But right now we're gonna open Photoshop. We're gonna get rid of this nasty English alphabet in my photos. Trust me, little changes like that change everything. Oh, this is a picture I'm working on. I'll show you all later. Okay, how are we gonna do this? Should we just do content? Let's see if that works, and if it doesn't work, we'll go in there with a brush. We're gonna try this first. If it doesn't work, we're gonna do this the manual way. Content aware. Oh, that worked. I didn't really have to do much of anything. I think that looks fine. I am shocked. How well that worked. Alright, I'm just gonna save it. Pretty cool, right? Wait, it's still saving. And I want these to be a little bit brighter. Oh wait, did I forget to feather? Okay, my bad. Should be okay though. I should go back to this place and see about shooting again. And how about we do something about these washed out colors? I'm feeling the teals. Go for that Blade Runner look. If I can. I don't think I can. Actually, what if I paint the sign? I don't think it does much. Oh well. Let's see if that changes anything. Maybe not. Erase that. Yeah, I think it's okay the way it is. Looks alright. Oh, this one's cool too. Let me just, let me try copy-pasting the settings and maybe... maybe it'll look okay. Yeah, her shorts kind of ruined it. I'm not feeling it. Let me try this one. Develop settings, where are you? What is going on here? You see all these kind of crazy things when you go back and edit your pictures. Like, actually, this one's cool, because I like pictures without people. This looks cool. I'm not gonna lie, this looks really cool. So, I wanna remove some brightness from between the lights. But not that much. Okay, maybe I'll just go for the shadows one. This would have been like a nice Cyberpunk 2077 picture to submit it, I think. But I won anyway, so don't matter. Yeah. Well, I won the public vote one. Which is not really... Not what I wanted, but I still got it, so it's okay. And it has cars. You guys know I hate cars in my photos. Yeah. I'm gonna leave the English there, because it's just gonna be like an art pack. Let's keep going. Let's see what more treasures I uncover. These old photos. Where is this? I think I was walking towards Jongno. This is my friend. This is art pack stuff. I'm gonna export that. Thank you very much. Thanks for liking the beginner photos. Man, I really sucked back then. I mean, I got lucky with a few shots, but took a long time to get where I am. Oh yeah, I remember this place. I have some photos from here already. Okay, so I am going to delete these pictures, including the raw files, because I already saved and have backed up and I need space. So I exported the ones I wanted. I'm gonna delete the RAWs, but my RAWs are still safe on a different disk. Don't do this. It's just me. I need space. And while that happens, this is awesome. I'm gonna go over here. Wait a minute. It's still exporting. I'm going to take these pictures, and the ones I like, I'm gonna put in my book folder for the future. And the ones I don't like, I'm gonna put them in the maybe folder. This was the old. Okay, next one we're gonna do is this one, but first, I need to open another folder. Book someday. Book, this is where I'm going to put the files that I absolutely want in my book. Like these two. Let's watch. View extra large icons. Maybe I want this one in the book. This one, yes. This one for sure. That one, yes. Which one? Okay, I want this one. That one, yes. I'm gonna cut these. Cut. And these are my book photos. Paste. Now, these pictures that are left over are pictures that are not bad. Oh, actually, there's more photos. I forgot. Okay, my bad. These two are gonna go in the book folder. And this is my book number two. These are pictures that are not terrible, but they're not good enough to be in my book. But maybe I might change my mind in the future. such as this one, I kind of like it. I think maybe I'll put it in the book folder after all. And this one too. These two are pretty good, I think. So, actually, I'm gonna change this one right now before I forget. Where's the paste? Okay, now these other pictures are not my best, but they're not bad. And actually, this is pretty cool. Wait a minute, let me do this again. This one is good-ish. This one is okay, but not great. These are for my art packs, but this one is awesome. Okay. I think it's just those. Okay, I'm gonna cut them. Book number two. And these pictures are going to be for an art pack I'm going to make for artists and photographers and stuff that they can use reference material for. So I'm gonna cut these, make art pack. Reference art pack. Oh, and while you guys are here, I'm gonna show you a preview of a picture I'm working on. I'm still editing it. It's kind of an anime style picture. Yeah, this is not done. No judging. Okay, so let's continue editing. Okay, so it's book two. This one's empty. We're going down the list through all these pictures. These are for like 2017, as you can see. I already edited 2016, 2015 photos. So where was I? Right here. Oh man, this is gonna be a lot of files. Okay, how many pictures is this? By the way, if the stream finishes or something, that's because it might have overheated. Okay, this is only 48 photos. I think, actually I don't know which camera I use here. One of the Fujis. Okay, these pictures are, my friend. Oh, I think not sure I like these photos. Oh, my art packs. I have links on my Twitter. If you go to my Linktree. I have wallpapers, prints, phone cases, stickers, free tutorials, reference images for artists, Patreon stuff, and if you want to be a bud and help me out, you can give me a dollar or two. That's always nice. So, what happened? Here, I was trying to do what the YouTuber said, but I don't like it. As you can see, everything's overexposed and not my style. This is a cool place though. I want a picture without people. I mean, it looks alright, but I don't like her clothes, to be honest. His either. Still, it's a decent photo. Maybe I should auto. I'm gonna export this probably as a reference pack picture. Whoops, that's too much. It's still a good photo. I mean, it's not it's good if it weren't for these people and their tacky fashion. You know, I'm not a fan of tacky stuff. Export. Should be better if I just I just put it there. I don't like regular non-rainy photos so much. We here just going through old pictures, rediscovering ourselves. What's this teenager doing in the middle of downtown at like midnight? We're just going through old pictures and we're editing old stuff and I'm putting them in a book. Oh yeah, this is a place called a Penis Park in South Korea. It's a real place. You don't believe me? Like, don't flag me for this stuff. This is a real place. It's called Haesindan Park. You can Google it yourself. Yeah, real place. And if you look for videos, you can find videos I made back in 2012 when I used to be a vlogger.
Okay.
Look at me, young man. And yeah, I used to make videos about Korea, you know, in my Spanish channel. It's a real place. Yeah, I know. I used to do videos about Korea. I better stop before I get copyright strike.
But yeah, I really enjoy.
Damn, I forgot about the copyright strikes. Well, I'm not really a tips person. I'm more of a, yeah, that's cool. I mean, I'll check it out, but I'm not a feedback giving kind of person. Cause I'm just a regular guy, you know. Oh yeah, I take a lot of pictures of clouds. You don't see much of those. I think it's penises. Okay, so where were we? What happened? Okay. Remove. Wait, we gotta delete these pictures first. But yeah, I used to be a travel blogger and food blogger around Korea. So I have a lot of weird stuff like that, videos I made back in the day. Where was I? Did I delete it already? Okay. Let's open the next folder. I'm pretty sure it already did. Because there was some music in there that was free at the time. But, you know, people who give the free music on YouTube, sometimes down the line they change their mind, and then whatever videos you made with that music that was free is not free anymore, and then you're basically screwed. So that's why I don't use music anymore so much. Like, people tell me, hey, when are you gonna make videos of that lo-fi music and all that stuff? Like, I want to, but I just get like the copyright strikes a few months later after they tell me that it's free, and then no money from that video, you know? I don't like that. Okay, I remember this is with the Super Takumar 50 1.4, nice vintage lens.
Okay, give me a second. I'm stretching.
Yeah, I could probably get more views if I use those, but all the money goes to the person who made the music, you know, so then I don't really get anything out of it. That's what sucks. Ah, man, the Super Takumar is so nice. So that's what sucks. This is a nice photo. I used to do so many landscapes and cityscapes back in the day. This is nice, it's just a simple photo. Export to the reference art pack. Wait. This is not with a Takumar. Never mind. Sorry. This is. This is with a DSLR. Oops. It happens. But it's okay. Exports. This would be good for book, but I cut this off. So my bad. I made a big mistake. I live in the north side near Korea University. Like, nobody ever comes over here. When people visit Korea, they only go to Hongdae, Gangnam, and Myeongdong, and that's it. Maybe they go to Namdaemun. But no one ever visits like the real Korea, like the non-touristy spots Korea, you know what I mean? That's one of the reasons I started taking these pictures, is so I could show people. Is this me? Is that my friend? So I remember I told my friend to take a photo of me. Damn, I was fat back then. I hope that's not my friend. As you can see, I'm starting to get more into the cyberpunk stuff. You hungry? You wanna eat? 1 second, let me check how... Let me see if I can order some food or something. Because we're having a good time editing right now. And I want to continue editing. Let's see, do I have any funds for food? And yes, I do. Okay, 1 second. I have this much money. Buy something good for us, and I'll give you the money. Go. Let me stream in peace. Get us something delicious. Okay? Okay? Man, I hope she doesn't take all my money, because I don't have that much. Okay, I'm gonna... The music might sound softer because I'm gonna charge it. But yeah, as you can see, I'm starting to get into the cyberpunk stuff. This is cool. Korea is okay, you know. I mean, every country has its ups and downs, but it's pretty safe. You can go anywhere. For photography, is great. It's great for guys, not so much for women. Let's see. Is that you? Probably not. I hope not. Okay, like, people like these kind of views because they're different from what they see. Like, I can post this picture and people tell me, wow, that looks awesome, and get like thousands of likes. But I don't like it. It's too... I don't want to say basic, it's just like... This is the kind of stuff you see a lot on Instagram, and I don't want to do like that, you know what I mean? Even though it's different from what I usually post. For me, it's just too common of a shot. This is like the Street Guru's app shot that tells you shoot at this kind of angle challenge. You know what I mean? Has anyone ever told me that? Maybe once or twice, but... Usually I just take a picture and I get out of there before they even notice that I took a picture. You know what I mean? Because a lot of people are like, I'm so shy about taking photos, blah blah blah. And I'm like, man, I just take a picture before they even realize what happened, and then I'm out of there, you know? So there's no way they're gonna catch me being shy. This is gonna be another reference shot. So yeah, just take a photo before anyone knows you're even there. This is one of the pictures I took for my wallpapers. I remember this picture. I like this spot very much. This is good wallpaper. This one's even better maybe. I think we're gonna use this one. I don't like the yellow though. And oh, let me see. 1 second. I'm gonna decide on the food. Bulgogi. Okay, I'll take that. The camera I was using at this time didn't have an ISO limit, or if it did, I didn't know about it. I just kind of let it go as high as it wants, because Usually cameras these days, they can go up to maybe 6,000 and you're still fine with the ISO. Usually I try to stay under 2,000, but since I'm shooting in auto, I don't really pay attention to it. The only time I pay attention to my ISO is if I'm doing a portrait shoot, because then I'm shooting manual. If I'm doing a landscape, because it's always 100 when you're doing landscapes. Or if I'm doing like product photography, you know what I mean? Like the rest of the time, I don't really care or pay attention to it. Here we go. This is nice. This is book material. Except for this cable that's in the way. You can't really do anything about it. I don't like it now. But yeah. I don't pay attention to my settings because I shoot in manual most of the time. I mean in auto most of the time. And my justification for that is photographers don't usually buy photographers' books or pictures or prints, right? They're the pixel peepers. They're the ones who zoom in. They're like, oh, there's some noise there. I can't buy that. Or there's some dark corners. The people who actually buy your pictures are not photographers. They're just normal people who they see the picture and they're like, oh, that reminds me, that takes me back to when so-and-so. And they don't care about the noise or anything like that. So that's why I don't worry about it. I'm going to put this one in the Korea project book. And I'm going to take this other picture, which is not bad. But I'm going to put this one in the reference pack. So I hope this gives you some explanation as to how I see things. Hopefully. Yeah, because like, I take pictures for people. I don't take pictures for photographers. If that makes sense. Reference art pack. But yeah. I don't know the ISO performance of cameras these days. But you know, cameras are really good these days. I don't think it matters what ISO they use. This is a good reference picture. Yeah, like a lot of people, they want to ask me all these technical questions and they're missing the point. They don't, they're the kind of people that look at a picture and be like, oh man, there's no noise in the shadows, that's a good photo. But they don't look at the whole picture, you know what I mean? Like, people want pictures of things they can connect with. Like, oh, I went to Korea and I ate at a restaurant that looks like that. It really takes me back, so I'm gonna buy your print because it reminds me of the time I had a restaurant there or something, you know? Oh, this is good. I mean, it's not rainy, so it's not gonna fit the theme of my book, but it looks pretty cool. Anyways, where was I? Yeah, people want something they can connect with. Photographers are the ones that are critical about all this other stuff that no one else cares about. Oh man, I think my wife's ordering something expensive. Oh, this is good. This is a good picture right here. Now, I can't tell you why it's good. In the other set, I had this picture, but it was framed differently and these lights weren't on, so the mood was different. But I came back to the same spots and I took this photo because I liked it. but I want it more blue and red. Yeah, well, I like explaining. Like, I have a goal, you know. I want to change. Oh man, this is really good. This is print material. For me, anyways. I don't know about other people, but this is the kind of thing I like very much. What was I saying? Oh yeah, I wanna. The reason I made this channel is because no one was making the kind of videos I wanted. Nobody was saying the kind of message I wanted to get out there about photography. It was all just buy this, buy that, blah blah blah. Yeah, maybe that's too much. I want to. I want to help people, you know, by letting them know that photography doesn't need to be expensive or anything. Wow, this picture is super crisp. Yeah. I mean, I get a lot of hate from other street photographers. They're like, it's not street photography if there's not people in the picture, blah blah blah, but I don't care about labels. This is good stuff right here. Korea project. Okay, I'm very happy with this. Let's see. Let's keep looking. This is the same picture I showed you before in the other set, but it sucked back then. This really goes to show that lighting is everything. But I kind of remember I wanted kind of a purplish tone to it. Not like that. Something like that. That's what I was going for. And I reduce the contrasts a little bit. I want the violets. And we gotta fix these lights, so we're gonna go back in there with a brush. And so yeah, I guess you just can say every photographer has a different eye, and some like something, others don't. So, like me, I'm not really into like nude photography or black and white so much like that. But I don't go around telling people, oh, that's not photography, that sucks, blah blah blah. Why would anyone look at that? But there's a lot of people, especially here on YouTube, that try to tell people what they should like, you know. And that annoys me. This is awesome. Okay, I am very happy with this shot. Fantastic. And this one would be like a good reference pack. This would be a good picture too. Like, I would put this in a book. It looks great. Ah, it's so hard to choose sometimes. I guess I'll keep it there, just in case. Oh, I just, what did I do? I didn't restore the light. I just changed the white balance. Sometimes changing the white balance changes the entire photo. You know what I mean? Like, let me show you. Oh, I guess that wasn't. I don't know. Sometimes just changing the tones and the shadows changes the entire thing. Even if you didn't play with the settings, you know? that's why I play around a lot with the colors and see what works best for me. Yeah, just changing the white balance changes everything. Oh. Do we have anyone that speaks Korean in here? Cause, actually, maybe this one's cool. The arrow or the red sign? I think we'll go with this one. For anyone here who isn't Korean, this is a Sungin Yongpun, means sex toys. Sex toys, second floor. Yeah, I just thought I'd throw that in there. I'm playing with the white balance tool, and over here it gives me like a good preview of what it's gonna look like if I change it. But actually, I like this kind of red-green look already. I don't think I'm going to change the white balance. I do like this teal, so I'm going to increase the saturation of the greens. Alright man, get some good sleep. Thanks for joining the stream. I'm gonna keep streaming until the food arrives. And yeah, thank you for the support. I always appreciate it. This is going in the book. Wow. Well, I appreciate people watch my streams because, you know, the other channels are bigger and they get like hundreds of people on their live stream. So I'm always thankful if I can get a few to watch my live stream. I always come back to this place. It's always good. But like I say, I don't like the tacky fashion. Find a picture of where there's not someone in there. Oh, they were. Yeah, she's wearing a mask back then. A lot of people wear masks even without the pandemic, you know? Like, I wear a mask a lot. Before this pandemic started, I was wearing a mask a lot. This one's actually alright, but I want to know if I took a picture without people in it. Maybe I didn't. Oh, that sucks. But it's okay. These are old photos. So you can see the progression in my pictures from when I first started. Like, the first photo sucked, and then people wear a mask because they got a cold and they don't want to spread it to others, or pollution, or they have pimples and the girls want to hide the pimples, so they wear the mask. There's a lot of reasons. I wore it because pollution. I like the curve. It's a good reference image. This one is going. Actually, this would be a good book picture too, but I prefer reference pack. I like this one because it's different. Not because it's particularly better than anything else. It's just a different photo. And the colors contrast red and green. This is good for reference. Where's the food? Okay, I'm gonna go through all my pictures and gonna save the ones I want in a book. So expect lots of streaming these days, especially since I can't go to work because of the virus. I like this picture, but when I make the book, I want it to be about rainy weather, so it's just one of those pictures that I like, but I don't have a use for. But I can still share with like Patreon and stuff. So this is going to reference pack. This was when I was making a video with Icon TV here in Korea. See, we were supposed to start school normally last month because the virus was down and everyone was doing so good. But then, and nothing against religious people because I'm actually a Christian myself, but the church people started these protests. Huge protests, they came from all over the country, and they had like church gatherings when they were not supposed to, and then the virus like pretty much exploded, and those people went back to their hometowns and spread the virus everywhere pretty much. Okay, I'm gonna delete these files, remove delete from disk because I have backups already. So now there is no no, we're back in quarantine. School is canceled, work is canceled, shops, bars canceled. You know, kind of sucks. Okay, so yeah, we're gonna go through this whole list, edit all of these photos, and put some in the book, Photoshop. Okay, next one is June 18 with my friend John. Oh, and my friend Diego. Okay. We're gonna edit until the food comes out. Oh, is this a time lapse? Oh, I think it's a time lapse. Oh, it's okay. While we wait for these pictures, we're gonna go back to our book someday projects. Here's my Korea project. These are the good pictures. If I make a book, they're going to go in there. Yeah, these are like my best pictures that I wanna put in a book someday. You know, these are my best of my best. This one is definitely one of my best pictures. I took this in Macau. That really sucks because the virus is definitely real and it's killing a lot of people. So these are some of my best pictures, you know. I got a lot of hate, like, I got a lot of hate here on YouTube and on places like Reddit, like,
That's not photography. That's not sharp. There's noises. The corners are dark. Blah, blah, blah. Too over-edited. But, you know, they're not my audience. My target audience is people who like pictures like this, like me, like cyberpunk style photos, who look at this and think, damn, that's cool, that looks like Blade Runner or Ghost in the Shell, you know. This is my audience, the people who like that kind of stuff. Oh, it's a public domain jazz radio, because I don't want to get copyright strikes, so just type public domain jazz. And here it is, public domain for you. But yeah, these are like my best pictures. And here's some of my infrared work, if you're not familiar with it. I mean, I'm not gonna talk trash about the infrared pictures that people here on YouTube take, but most of them don't even edit their infrared pictures. They're like, oh, this is infrared, there you go, video done. Like, they gotta take the time to actually edit the photo. Like, this is my picture, my tutorial, but this one's edited. These are just not edited. This one's straight out of the camera. Yeah. See, like, when they just leave it like that, okay, that's cool, but if you actually edit like Matthew, you get these cool effects, you know. But these actually are like newer videos. Like, before I came along and started doing these tutorials, all the pictures just looked like flat red. Everything was just like red, red, white, red, red. No editing. But yeah. These are my phone pictures. I did this when I was doing my phone photography project. This one, you can tell the colors kind of break down, but I actually like the way it looks. It looks really cool, even if I'm pushing the camera to the limits, you know? And here's another infrared picture. There was a couple, and they're taking a couple photos, and I stepped in. I told them, yeah, can I take your photo? And they're like, okay. And then I was like, can you give them a kiss? And they're like, okay. Voila. And I sent them the picture. I told them I would send them their photo. So yeah, I have lots of kinds of styles. This is a red light district. All these are like red light places. But I like the way you can see the rain and everything in the reflections. It's just, yeah. But yeah, let's get back to editing. Wait, did I copy these pictures already? Okay, I gotta make sure I did before I continue. Book someday. Okay, I already did. Good. Then I can delete these. Okay, let's continue. There's a lot of pictures here for reference. This is a time lapse and shooting with my friend. I used to do a lot of landscapes, as you can see. Before street photography, I was a landscape photographer, and this is what I did. Actually, this would be a good wallpaper for Patreon. Export. Okay, so they're pretty much all the same photo. Because this was a time lapse I made for TV station or something. And then this is me. I think this was like a super wide lens. I was playing around with it. Everything's really crazy. But this was like an adapted lens, so a lot of bad photos. It's okay, it happens. These pictures are not very exciting for me, so I'm just gonna like, meh. Though they make good reference. Lots of cute girls. It's my friend, I think. This would be a good reference image. Korea. I don't like good looking cities. I like the crappy ones. The crappy ones are the best. this is going to be reference material for artists. If I was in Germany or America or some place that's lots of rural and town stuff, then I would probably do a lot of close-up photography. Like with like a what's it called, telephoto lens, a lot of close-ups. Let's see, why did I take this photo? Well, that does look kind of cool, but really noisy there. Okay. Reference material. Okay, what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna reduce the contrast, increase the luminance. Oh. And maybe I'll give it some green. But not too much. And this is going to be a reference picture for artists. You guys hear me say that a lot. I'm making reference packs for artists. So if you know anyone who likes drawing and they need some pictures for inspiration, they can use my photos. These are too dark. Why did I take this photo? I don't remember. Oh yeah, I think she was throwing up earlier. Over here. That was some time ago though, I don't remember. Too dark. Kinda like this though. Yeah, this is why I was underexposing by two stops at the time, so it was a big mistake, but I was just learning. Even though I got lucky with some shots, you know what I mean? Yeah, I think some of these are going to be a little too dark to use. Oh, this was a cool place. I remember the best picture I took here was with the phone. It's more like a hobby that pays for itself. Like, because of my notoriety, I am able to get jobs as a photographer. Like magazines, TV stations, cell phone manufacturers, like that. But the money I make from prints is just kind of extra money that I can... Okay, for example, my computer was overheating, but thanks to the money from Patreon, I was able to fix it. And my computer... No, my camera broke last year. But I was saving all the money from Patreon, YouTube, prints, and donations that people give me. And I was able to use that money to buy a new camera, you know? Well, not a new camera, but a new used camera. And that was more than enough for me. I don't need the great latest greatest. I just need like a camera that works. This is alright, but I made a mistake of shooting it too dark. Okay, these photos are not that great, but there's some good stuff here and there. Like, this is cool. Oh, it's public radio, dude. It's not a playlist. Just go to public domain radio and... It's right here. Wait, type radio. See? Right here. Public domain jazz, public domain classical. Oh, I didn't notice there's some guy here. Ah, dang. It's kind of opening for a photo without people. Well, I guess it kind of adds to the atmosphere. It would be so nice if it wasn't for these guys in the way. Okay, so I'm gonna go ahead and delete from the disk, raw files included. Because, as I already said before, I already made a backup of these files, so I don't have to worry about that. And this picture is going to my book projects. Book someday. I think the food is coming. Is the food here? Maybe not. Is the food coming? Okay, guys, I think the food has arrived. Wait, no, not yet. Oh, it's here. Okay, I'm going to end the stream, but I'll be streaming maybe in like 6 hours because it's supposed to rain. Buenas noches. Oh, is the día aquí. So, yeah, thank you for everything. And just for watching me and stuff. That's always nice. And, yeah, let's stream again 6-7 hours from now. I'll do like a walk in the rain live stream. If it rains. If it doesn't rain, I'm just going to stay home. So, thank you very much and goodbye.